Hello and welcome to all guys. My name is Mohit and here I am back with another YouTube video. So in this video, I'm gonna tell you how to deal with the feeling of nervousness, especially when it comes to talking in English. See, before getting to the actual content of the video, I'm gonna just tell you something about nervousness, okay? See, nervousness is something which is quite not new to you. You've been in that situation before, okay? What do I mean by that? You know what? We have been facing this nervousness ever since we have born into this earth. Like the very first moment we tried to walk like a baby, when we were baby, we were trying to walk or crawl, then we were having that feeling of nervousness even that moment. Okay, and then we worked hard on that, just like by walking, continuously walking, falling down continuously, and then we are able to walk properly. Okay, so that was very, very young age when you were quite small, and that's when you faced the situation. Now you'll say that the situation at that time and at the current situation that you are facing right now, it's different altogether. Well, there's not any difference. See, what happened, even at that time, you were not mature enough to overcome that thing, but still you worked hard on yourself. It's only then you're able to walk. I know it's a lot to, you know, grasp thing, but still I want to tell you one thing that you just have to relate. Okay, the younger you, the infant you, was just like the current you. I know the situation around you is quite different, but the sense of strength, okay, is still within you, and it's as strong as it was earlier. Okay, that was quite deep and that was way too kind of motivating thing. So I'm gonna talk about this nervousness, okay? It's something which is quite not new to you, okay? You've been in that situation before, you have panicked before, but it's just that the situation that you're facing right now is different. How? This question comes to your mind, how it's different from the early situation. Well, you were aware of this term nervousness, okay? But you have never exaggerated this term. Exaggeration, what does it mean? I mean, exaggeration you have done in your mind. You are feeling nervousness. You have kind of exaggerated this term a lot, that whenever this term, or whenever you come across something like panic like situation, you call it as the nervousness, and you be like, you just went overboard. Like you overreact. Nervousness, if you're feeling nervous, it's quite normal. You have to accept this fact that it's totally normal to feel nervous. And especially when it comes to speaking English, of course, I've also been in that situation before. The situation that you're facing right now, I've also been in that situation. It's only then I overcome that situation, and now here I am presenting for you. But you know what? I make mistake. I also get nervous, especially when it comes to facing the camera right now. Like this video, I deleted this video and I recorded this again. Okay, I can do that, because I'm at my place and doing this thing, but not every time you can do that. No, undo things, redo things, you cannot do that. Especially when you're in the public event, or when you're just like in the live situation, you cannot do that. Of course, it's just not possible. So all you have to do is to work hard on that, is to work continuously on that. It's only then you will get to see the results. So that was it about the nervousness, okay? What do I mean by that? The old thing that I've just told you, just to work hard and all. What do I mean by that? Okay. Especially, I faced the situation before, like I said, and in that situation, but I find my own experience that I'm telling you, that I learned some vocabularies and I tried to talk, and I was able to talk for a few minutes, and I find myself, yeah, quite motivating that I am able to talk. Of course, I'm very good at English and I can talk, so that's what motivating me, okay? But when it comes to interaction with others, you know, communicating with others, I find myself in a situation like I have to work a little hard on myself, I guess way more hard on myself. It's only then I'll be able to communicate with others. So that was kind of frustrating, that at moments you feel like, yes, you were high on emotions, like yes, you can do that, but when you face it live, you'll be like, no, you have just like taken a small step. All you need, there's a full ladder here to take multiple steps okay? And it's only then you will reach the position, okay? That was the situation, okay? So what I did, I practiced. How I practice? I talk. Whatever the shit that I have in my mind, I used to blurt out everything, and that too in English language. So talking, interaction is way more important thing to deal with this problem of nervousness that you think it's way too hard to deal with. But actually it's not. It's kind of challenging. It's kind of complicated. Yes, it is. I'm not neglecting this. It's not complicated or it's hard to deal with. It's just impossible to deal with. But yes, it is. I won't say it's impossible, but yes, you can deal with this. And of course, like I did, just you have to be calm. You have to be patient and keep on practicing. That's all you have to do. See, what I did, I used to talk whatever the shit that I had in my mind. Like, it's not about, I used to take up some topics, like you have to talk for a few minutes on that topic and interact with my friend as well. Sometimes I get friends, it's only then I was able to do that, interact with the person. But it's not always like that. So I took up the camera, Sometimes I do use that, but in that situation, in my situation, I never used the camera. I used to stand before the mirror and I used to talk to myself. So I talked. It's not like I talked for a few minutes. It's like I used to continue this practice for days, okay, for weeks, for months. I practiced this daily. I used to talk whenever I feel like, in my leisure time or whenever I feel like doing something, I'd be like, let's talk in English, whatever the situation it is. Whatever means whatever you have in your mind, I just blurt out everything in that in English, and that's what it's motivating me. So you have to accept this fact that it's okay to feel nervous, but with hard work, with perseverance, you can deal with it. So that's how you're supposed to deal with the situation. Well, I guess I'm not able to clear how to deal with that exactly. Well, there are a few points that you can keep in your mind when it comes to when you feel nervous. So first thing is you have to accept this fact. Yes, I'm feeling nervous. How can I do that? When you feel nervous, you have these questions in your mind. How can I do that? How am I able to present before the others? It's okay. When you feel this nervousness, okay, just tell yourself, just take a deep breath and tell yourself, yes, you can do it. Although you're feeling nervous, but still, you can give your best. Accept this fact. And the second most important point is practice. Yes, there is no substitute for that. All you have to do is practice as much as you can. And I know you will say that, okay, I don't have any people, you know, I don't find any person around me who will talk to me, who will be ready to talk to me in English. It's okay. I've been in a situation before. I also face the situation. People around me don't really talk in English. They don't really want to interact in English. They be like, if you want to talk in Hindi, it's fine. If you want to talk in English, I'm leaving. Their reaction was that. The response was that kind of thing. So you have to be your own friend, and you have to be you as well to talk in English, okay? So you have to practice as much as you can. And whenever, okay, the third point is about whenever you find situation, like where you're supposed to present something in English, like you have to be like very active, especially like in school. If you're in school, in college, then I would suggest you do, whenever you encounter something where you have to present something in English language, or just be the first one, okay, to do that. Raise your hand and tell your teacher, your lecturer, that yes, I'll be the one who'll perform that thing. And because if you take challenging tasks, of course that will not only increase your confidence but also help you to deal with the nervousness. When you feel confident, of course you'll sound way more better than you can ever think of. You know, sometimes when I talk to myself and I say some amazing things, and I feel like, was it me? Was it really me who was saying those things? So that's how the practice, you know, practice like a miracle. It does miracle on you. Yes, of course, you have to accept this fact that practice does a lot of good on you. So it's only then you will be able to deal with it. And as for the nervousness, don't exaggerate this term. Next time when you feel the nervousness, accept this. It's okay. I'm nervous. Yes, I'm nervous. It's totally fine. I'm feeling nervous. But I will do that. I'll present my best. That's the spirit you should have whenever you encounter something like that. I know it's not possible all the time, but I know you can do that. You know, you can do that, okay? So that's the next video. Stay tuned for the coming videos where I'm gonna talk about some important topics, like just like I talked today about the nervousness. I'm gonna take up another topics as well. So stay tuned to my channel and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more such videos.